Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.4 Developer Beta 1. This is available to all developers now if you are a developer, and soon to public beta testers. So by the time you're watching this video, it could be out, but at the time of recording this video, it's not. Now this came in at 4.45 gigabytes on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and it's going to be a huge install when you're going from a public version, iOS 14.3, to a beta version, iOS 14.4 betas. And so it was about 4+ gigabytes on all the devices here, my iPhone 11, my 12.9 iPad Pro from 2020, and the iPhone 6S Plus. They all were huge installs. And it did take a very long time to process the install file and then install it, so it seemed longer than usual. Now, Apple also released iPadOS 14.4 Beta 1, tvOS 14.4 Beta 1, and watchOS 7.3 Beta 1. All of those are available to developers right now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number, and then we'll talk about what's new. So if we'll go into settings, we'll go over to general, then about. You can see the build number is 18D5030E. And this particular build was a little bit of a surprise. I forgot that last year around this time, Apple also released a beta with iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1. So that was kind of surprising. And they've done the same here, but only on December 16th. Last year it was December 17th. Now, they updated the modem firmware on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, so that should help with connectivity if you were having dropped connections with 5G and things like that. While that should have been fixed in iOS 14.3, apparently they needed to update the modem firmware, and it's updated on the 12 Pro Max and probably most devices, although I haven't confirmed on every device, but these are updated. Now, as far as new features, well, there's nothing that we can see specifically. This is a strange update in that they would push out a point update, meaning 14.3, 14.4, and not put anything significant in it. By the time it's released to the public, I would expect significant changes and updates, but right now there's nothing to see that's significant. In fact, in the notes, they only mention one thing, and they reference basically app clips, so where you can use your camera to take a photo of an app clip. So my friend Steve Moser pointed some of this out. It was in the notes, but it says iOS 14.4 beta release notes reference app clips as local experiences. And you can see there's app clip, scan only, and NFC integrated. If you bring your phone over it, it will recognize one and say no data found. But if you have app clips available, it will work as basically a local experience. There's nothing else new that's mentioned in the notes as far as fixes or anything else. However, I did ask quite a few people, is there still issues that you're having? So for example, do you have the HDR issue? Now the HDR issue, for those that don't know, was specific to the iPhone 12 series, where you would put an HDR video on, drop the lights down, and the backlight would look almost like it was an LCD backlight, where the black pixels that should be turned off looked like they had backlighting on them. It seems like that's fixed. I went into YouTube, played an HDR video, went to the TV app, played an HDR video, turned the lights off in the room, and I couldn't replicate that experience. So it wasn't showing at all, and it looks like it's fixed. Now, as far as the green tint issue, well, one person said that it was fixed on Twitter, but then Jury, that actually shared this video with me, is showing that it's not fixed. He shared this with me before. Let me turn off the lights. We'll turn up the brightness so you can see it. And there's the green tint issue. You can see on his lock screen that there's green tint, and it's not fixed. So this is something Apple needs to fix in the future, and they've said they're going to fix. So we're just waiting for that update, and hopefully we'll see it fairly soon. And then finally, to do with the screen being a little bit warmer, I don't think that's actually a bug. I think that's more of the phone being more accurate. I could be wrong about this with a yellow tint on it, but being maybe a little bit more color accurate than, say, the other phones, because it did win a bunch of awards for color accuracy. And if you've ever calibrated a display, it generally tends to look a little bit warmer than if it's not calibrated. So that's possible that it's just a little bit warmer and we're not used to it, and that's why it looks that way. Of course, I don't have a colorimeter to test that, but many places have actually tested it and said it's very accurate. So like I said, there's no known issues in this particular update, and the notes only said a resolved issue. So basically that you can now launch a local experience. Like I said, that was resolved. Apparently it wasn't working before, but it's basically like a new feature as well. So there isn't anything specific in this exciting or anything like that. That goes along with iPadOS too. So it gets all the same updates and the huge 4+ gigabyte update, but there wasn't anything specifically new new in here that I could find. Just going through, it doesn't seem like there's anything really exciting in it. So that's kind of interesting that Apple pushed this out. Now, as far as performance, well, I've been using it on these devices. So on the iPhone 6S Plus, for example, I just go in and check music usually and see how fast it loads. And it generally tends to have the same experience, just going into different applications. So if we go into things like weather, we'll give it a second to load, and there we go. So it seems like it's running like you would expect. So if we go back and just scroll, it seems fine. So it doesn't seem like it's any slower. And of course, I did a Geekbench to see what this actually comes in at, and it's a little better and a little worse. So if we go into Geekbench, I'm using Geekbench 5, and you can see on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, it scored 1,593 for single core, 4,151 for multi-core. If we look at the history, you can see that the multi-core score is slightly higher, where the single core score is slightly lower. So it's basically the same as iOS 14.3 when it comes to that. Now, if we take a look at the Geekbench on all of these devices, let me go back in here on the 11, the 6S Plus. So from left to right, I have the 12.9 inch 2020 iPad Pro, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, the iPhone 11, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So on all of these devices, it looks like it should have pretty good performance. It's really in line with what we had with iOS 14.3. So when should you expect the next update? Well, this is beta 1, and based off what we had last year, they released an early beta on December 17th, like I said earlier in the video. Then we had nothing else until January 14th. So I would not expect anything until January. Usually Apple takes a break. I just forgot about these betas. This was early on last year. They had iOS 13.3.1 beta 1 on December 17th, and then 13.3.1 beta 2 on January 14th, which means I wouldn't expect any updates, including public updates, until next year. However, Apple did say that they were going to fix that green tint issue by the end of the year. So it's possible they could push this out, but I find that very unlikely, and they'll probably push it until next year since people take vacations during the holidays and things like that. So should you install iOS 14.4 beta 1? Well, if you're on 14.3, I would say absolutely not, unless you want to beta test something, maybe develop different applications, things like that. I really don't advise installing beta updates this early on unless we know exactly how they are and how they're going to perform over time. So for example, it does take a few days to know how the battery life is. So my battery life on my iPhone 12 Pro Max running iOS 14.3, since that's what I've been running up to now, has been pretty good. Of course, I have 100% battery health, and updates don't affect it. It just rechecks it, but this is a newer phone, so it should be pretty high anyway. But the last 10 days, let's take a look at yesterday. I used 50% of my battery and had 4 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 34 minutes of screen off time. So if we extrapolate that out to double the time using 100% of the battery, it's about 9 hours of screen on time with about 1 hour of screen off time. So 10 to 12 usually, depending on the day, is going to vary greatly. But you can see from day to day, it looks like it's okay. And Twitter is doing a lot in the background, so I need to probably turn that off. I'm not sure why it is, and it shouldn't be. But other than that, it seems like battery will be okay. It will take a few days to know how it is in this particular update. And so, again, I wouldn't install this unless you're used to using betas. You don't mind the occasional bug if there's some found in this. And of course, I'll do a follow-up later to talk about what we find over the next couple of days. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description below. I think it's pretty interesting. You will need to resize the wallpaper for your device to get the sort of ring of light on the outside edge. So just resize it and it should work fine for you. It's the same wallpaper I have on all these devices, just resized. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.